I have to ask you, do you feel vindicated? The Fed actually at least somewhat caught up with you, I think, this week in saying we do, after all, have to be concerned about inflation, transitory or otherwise. So are you feeling good today?
David, look, I think the Fed signaled that it recognized that we were in a different place than it had expected on inflation. The best measure of that is if you look at what the market is now saying about real interest rates over the next few years, you saw an unprecedented, or nearly not unprecedented, but very large 5-standard deviation move in the market's expectation around real interest rates because of what the Fed signaled, principally with the dot plot. You saw that happening without the Fed changing in a major way its forecast of economic growth or its forecast of medium-term inflation, simply marking to reality its near-term inflation forecast. So I think you did see on Wednesday, a signal that the Fed had changed its reaction function in a significant way. I think that was an appropriate change given the inflation reality. There was a lot of volatility under the surface in markets, so I think they're still processing what happened, and you shouldn't try to read every detail as fitting together in a pattern. But I think yesterday will be remembered much, much more than most FOMC meetings as the beginning of the Fed's recognition that overheating is the issue that it has to deal with going forward. And given that overheating has been a major concern of mine, I'm glad to see that they have that recognition. But look, at a certain point, Churchill talked about it not being the end, not being the beginning of the end, but maybe it being the end of the beginning. And I think with respect to recognizing that the economy is now in a very, very different kind of place where demand pressures are a crucial issue, I think that's exactly what we have seen here. And I was glad to see in particular the change in the dot plot, which showed that the basic implausibility in a labor short economy of rates being at zero out to 2024 is something that now a majority of the members of the FOMC recognize.
Yeah, so Larry, they get the issue now. I think it's fair to say they've said they get 13 of the 18 members think the risk on inflation is the upside. So they get the issue, but are they doing anything about that issue? Because they moved some dots on their plot, to be sure, but they didn't actually cut back on their bond purchases, $120 billion a year, a month, as you pointed out. That's increasing the accommodation, much less touch the rates. And by the way, if anything, it's a little surprising the rate on the 10-year remained in the 1.5 range, and the equity markets, they sold off some, but it wasn't that dramatic. So are they doing anything about the fundamental underlying causes of this overheating, as you describe it?
I think we're going to have to wait and judge that. An optimistic view would be that because they signaled that they were on the case, that was reassuring to everybody that the accident that people feared was less likely to happen. And that's why equities were relatively tranquil. That's why the 10-year came down. After all, part of what the 10-year was pricing in was the risks I had been fearing, a significant increase in inflation or the need for a major tightening at some point. So I think an optimistic view of those developments would be that, in fact, by changing expectations and changing their signals, that is policy in the monetary sphere, and they were rewarded for it.
Larry, I certainly take your point about the danger of overinterpreting the markets and what they're telling us, but address one thing in particular, and that is the flattening of the yield curve, because one of the things that happened this week was a pretty dramatic flattening of the yield curve. So the short end came up because the Fed certainly could drive that quite immediately. At the same time, the long end didn't, if anything, came down. Does that reflect the fact that the markets might think that maybe they are getting their arms around inflation?
It reflects two things, and in just what proportions is hard to know. I think it reflects certainly an expectation that they may be getting their arms around inflation. But, you know, inflation expectations moved hugely between the beginning of the day yesterday and the end of the day yesterday. They moved way down at the beginning of the day. That would have been very much like what you said. But by the end of the day, they had moved back up by 10 basis points. That's why I'm resisting an overinterpretation of those data. It may also be that if you thought that we were going to need to have some kind of big collision between monetary policy and the economy, those kinds of collisions send long rates way up. And we probably have taken out a bit of the risk of that kind of collision. So, and we've made the world probably a safer place and taken risk premiums out. So I think all of those things are contributors to the flattening of the curve. But David, I've learned in this that it's easy to form a beautiful theory around a market pattern and then have that pattern dissipate on you 2 days later. And so I think the more detailed the pattern one's commenting on, the less confident one should be in prescribing a detailed theory.
Yeah, fair enough. A point really well taken. Larry, you've always been very careful in saying you're not going to advise the Fed on what it should do. So I won't ask you to advise it what it should do from here on out, but I'm going to ask you, based on what you know, given the fact it now recognizes the issue in inflation and where it is, what you expect over the next few months, because people are talking about when they might announce the tapering, when it might actually take effect, how long it would take, when we'll really get some rate increases.
Look, my guess is that inflation is obviously going to have a transient element. It's been running at 8%. Nobody thinks it's going to stay at 8%. The question is whether the transient element is 4% or whether the transient element is 6%. And so how far down it's going to come. And I think the transient element's a little smaller than many other people do. I think the Fed's watching the data very, very closely. You saw that in this statement. And so my guess is that the adjustments are going to come on the sooner side of the distribution of expectations rather than on the latter side of expectations. And if the data come in as I expect they will, that will certainly be an appropriate set of changes.
Larry, going back in time, you warned about the danger of overheating literally the day that President Biden announced his American Rescue Plan, about the massive fiscal infusion that he was asking for. So you got that issue early, and it appears that other people now are catching up. I'm going to push you now and say, what's the one we're missing? What's the next one around the corner that we may not be paying enough attention to?
I think we need to be careful what we do with our trade policies and our regulatory policies, and we need to make sure that we make the huge corrections that are necessary to Trump-era policy on taxes and regulation and microeconomics. We need to be raise the minimum wage. We need to be more supportive of unions than we have been. We need to do more on the green side. We need to raise corporate taxes. But I think we need to be careful to maintain a positive climate for business going forward.